Hello, and welcome to the back of my door. Today, we're going to look at comment sections, and I will be determining which social media platform has the worst comment section of all of them. I'm going to look at YouTube, I'm going to look at Instagram, I'm going to look at Twitter, I'm going to look at Facebook, and I'm going to look at TikTok, and using my flawless rating system, I'm going to decide which one is the worst comment section. It's going to be real math. As you can see, I have my ranking, I have a board.
Wow.
Which means that means I mean business. So I will be ranking these comment sections based on the four S's. Sincerity, how sincere the comments are, how serious they are. Sanity, which will account for randomness if the comments have anything to do with the post at all. Silliness, if they're funny, the comedic value of these comments. And stupidness, the overall quality, if they are stupid comments. Just if they're not good, up to my standards of what a comment should be. So, let's start, right? Start with YouTube, right? Let's do it. So, in order to keep this accurate, I'm gonna be taking a video off of the trending page of today and looking at that comment section. So, let's see what we have here. Let's go with Baby Mama Dance BFF Edition. That seems pretty YouTube. I'm just going right to the comments. The cutest. Y'all inspire me to want to have a friendship like you guys. That's pretty sincere. A lot of laughing, crying emojis. More laughing and crying, but a lot of laughing to them crying. That's not gonna bode well in the stupidness category. These all seem to pertain to the video. They're all mostly sincere. There's a lot of laughing till I'm crying emojis. Let's take a look at a different video. Let's take a look at this FaZe Clan takes a lie detector test. So I'm seeing a little bit of self-awareness, some more randomness, less crying till I'm laughing emojis. Let's try a music video. Let's try this number four. Moneybag Yo Spin on him. Featuring Frito Bang. This is way too gangsta. They're not even social distancing. That's a good one. That's a good comment. Nobody can beat the swag of Moneybag Yo. He is still going viral without using authentic ViewCom to get the views up. While many artists using this site to get more views. Thumbs up, who agrees? I think this is just a ploy to get people to use this website that he put in bold to get views. Damn, listen to this song about 1,000 times already. Fire Hunted. Thank you for your comment, Buy Spotify Plays. If you guys are in the market for Spotify Plays, just hit up Buy Spotify Plays to buy Spotify Plays. Who here before a million from Spotify StreamsBot? If you guys want to get Spotify StreamBots, just hit up Spotify StreamBots to get some Spotify StreamBots. Only people who didn't come from TikTok are worthy of liking this. I literally just read this up here from 10K subs with videos, ? So you stole that. I mean, honestly, both of these accounts seem pretty fraudulent, so let's just say they both stole it from somebody else.
In the criminal justice system, all defendants are innocent until proven guilty.
I'm gonna have to add a new category for stealing and or weird bot shit. We're gonna have to, okay, so that's YouTube. Honestly, I'm pretty disappointed. I thought I was gonna find some actual decent stuff here, but hold on, I'm gonna fix some stuff real quick. Okay, so I've added two more S's. The four S's have become the six S's after what I've seen. So we've added spam for weird bot accounts and like stupid shit like that, and stealing for people copying comments, because that is that's a problem. So from what I've seen from YouTube, sincerity, there was a few with sincerity. I'm ranking these all out of five, by the way. So out of five, I would give sincerity on YouTube. I'd give sincerity a 3. Sanity, there was a little bit of randomness, not that much, so I'm gonna give it a 2 for sanity. Silliness, how funny they were. Again, a couple funny ones, mostly not funny. That's also gonna be a 2. Stupidness, how stupid they were. I saw a lot of stupid stuff that I just didn't, not very quality comments, not stuff that was making a point that was worthy of actually being there as a comment, so I'm gonna give stupidness. There's a lot of laughing, crying emojis, so that's gonna be up to a 4. I'm sorry, YouTube. Okay. Spam. A lot of spam on that music video. It's gotta be a 3. And stealing. There was one case of stealing, but that does not bode well. I'm gonna have to give it a 2 for stealing. Yeah. Okay. So overall, let's tally this up, shall we? So this is a total of 16 points out of out of a possible 30. 16 out of 30 points. Wow, just a little bit more than half, which is definitely an F. That's not good. YouTube, what? Okay, all right, we're moving on. I'm gonna move on to Instagram from here. Hopefully they fare a little bit better, but we'll see. Maybe, I have a prediction, maybe all comment sections are bad. To keep this fair, I'm gonna look for who has the most followers on Instagram. Most followers on Instagram. Really? Cristiano Ronaldo? Okay, that's strange, but all right, we're gonna look at Cristiano Ronaldo's Instagram page, I guess. Okay, let's look at his latest post. 25,000 comments, a lot of emojis, hearts and claps and faces with hearts and laughing, crying, and hearts and things in Spanish. You are powerful, my guy. Very nice to picture. Yeah, okay, so I don't know how this will set my rankings, but we'll figure out, I guess, as we go. Selena Gomez. Oh, yeah, 444. Let's go to Selena Gomez, right? Let's see what her comment section's like. Makeshift Studio. Okay, whoa. That's almost 50,000 comments. Okay. Emojis. Girl, check this. Fire, fire. Somebody's just spamming different emojis. Flower, crown, flower, crown. Okay. Hey, weenie. You bully me. Okay, this is even... I didn't think this was possible, but this makes even less sense to me than the Cristiano Ronaldo post with all the Spanish. This is a big paragraph about some garbage that I do not care about. The best news you can receive this period is to receive financial consistency. I was really broke and worried about the future when I came across testimonies of traders who've invested with Mrs. Sarah. I traded with $500 and made $4,650 every week. Oh my. Sarah Douglas. Guys, I think I don't even have to finish this video. I found a way to completely bypass all. I can just be rich. If I follow Mrs. Sarah, I can make $4,650 a week. I don't think you guys understand this. The secret to financial success was in the Selena Gomez comment section all along. Oh my God. There's another one. I have a group of friends who invest with Linux options, but I tried mine for the first time last week and now I know what I have been missing. I'm rich in a couple months. Account manager Amber. Not only did I find one route to riches and wealth through Selena Gomez's comment section, I found two. I'm gonna be double rich. That's enough of that bullshit. I guess to balance this out, I should probably look for maybe a meme account. We'll have some. Let's just go with memes. This is what my husband and I purchased today at the grocery store the other day. We don't have kids. We are adults, we pay bills, and I drink water from our whale. Money well spent. This is who made this meme? Literally me crying, oh geez. This is not a good meme page. I think I picked a bad one. I had one of those. It was actually lit. Cool, Tyler. Thank you, Tyler. All right, I thought this meme page would sort of redeem these comment sections, but not really. So let's get to the scoring. There's a glare, and you can't really, just pretend this is Instagram. Okay, sincerity. There's a few, especially in the Cristiano Ronaldo, there's some sincerity, I assume, through all the emojis in Spanish. So I'm gonna give sincerity a 4. Well, yeah, a 4. Sanity, there wasn't as much randomness as I thought there'd be. There was a little bit. That's gonna be 2 out of 5. Silliness, there was really not that many funny comments. Almost none. Almost none of them were funny. That's gonna be a 1 for silliness. I really thought Instagram would do better in the silliness category. Stupidness, if there were good comments. No. Almost 0. That's gonna be a 4 in stupidness. I think I'm ranking stupidness wrong. I guess you want to rank low in stupidness, right? Because it's the amount of stupidness you don't have. Okay, it's gonna be a 2. Spam, there's a good amount of spam, especially from crypto investment or whatever the hell that was. 3 for spam. Stealing, I did not see any stealing. Does that mean it doesn't happen? There's definitely stealing happening everywhere. But I didn't see it, so I'm gonna put that as a 1. No, wait. I'm doing the rankings wrong again. No stealing, which means it's a good score, right? So that's gonna be a 4. Okay, let's tally it all up. 14, 15, 16. Are you kidding me? 16 again? And there might be something wrong with my ranking system, but I think I'm ranking stupidness wrong. For now, we're just gonna go with also a 16. If they all, okay, well, we'll see. Okay, on to Twitter. So for Twitter, I'm just gonna go to the news section, whatever, and go to like the trending tab and see what's been trending, I guess. Number one on trending is how Elon Musk and Grimes have named their baby this. Okay, so we've got the Sky News tweet talking about how Elon Musk and Grimes have welcomed baby XA or A12. Sounds like name of an android, and there are some comments. Let's see. Well, when you're a genius, I suppose your baby will have a genius name. It says a lot that people in the comments don't understand the meanings. AE is a symbol for Ash. Lockheed A-12 was the name for the Archangel plane. Hence, Ash Archangel Musk.
I guess I don't know a lot about being a genius, but is naming your baby Ash Archangel a genius thing to do?
I was going to call my baby that. The next SpaceX rocket is called George. I'm going to assume there was a mix-up. That's pretty good too. Aw, he looks like NXAEA-12. These are pretty good. I'm pleasantly surprised with how actually funny a lot of these Twitter replies are. Okay, I mean, yeah, we're off to a good start here. Let's do a different topic. Number two, Cinco de Mayo is trending. I'm recording this on Cinco de Mayo. Got this weird video of somebody dancing in a sombrero and a poncho. That's the blackest man I've ever seen. Okay, well, let's try one last hashtag. Let's try a Teacher Appreciation Day, whatever the hell that's about. Somebody selling medical masks? That's a spam. More spam about medical masks. Oh my god. What the hell is going on? There's so many. All right, so that's a lot of teachers and people that like teachers. Okay, so I think I've got a good idea of what Twitter's like. Let's do the scoring. Twitter. So there's some sincerity. Not a lot. I saw only certain hashtags had actual sincere tweets. So I'm going to rank that a 2. Sanity. Not a lot of randomness. I saw most things applied to what they were being talked about. So I'm going to also rank sanity as a 4. Silliness, comedy. This is where I got a lot of good chuckles out of the little comments I read, the replies. I think that's going to be a 5, to be honest. This is doing way better in silliness than any other section I saw. Stupidness. There's a little bit of stupidness. There's a little bit of a laughing till I'm crying emoji, so I'm going to give that a 2. No, wait. 4. 2. Wait. Shit. You don't want more stupidness, okay. So with the lack of stupidness, I'm gonna give it a 4. Spam, there was a lot of spam on that teacher appreciation thing that's not boding well, especially because it was the same exact thing over and over again. You're gonna get a 2 for the spam section. And stealing, I didn't see any stealing, so I'm gonna give that a 4 as well. Dude, I definitely messed up these rankings. So this all adds up to 21. Wow, that's a pretty decent score. Seems we have a front runner for best comment section, folks. Beautiful. All right, let's move on to Facebook. I'm not excited about that. I looked up who the most followed person on Facebook is, and again, it's Cristiano Ronaldo again somehow. I don't know how this man is like the biggest like person ever of all time. So let's take a look at these comments. This guy's a top fan. Back where I don't understand where you separated, now you're back, but I didn't know that. Why didn't know? I know that I should have known so I could something for a while. That got 202 likes and upvotes. Isn't that okay? You are the best for me. You are the strength. You are the best father. A lot of these seem to be from people that the English isn't their first language, so that's understandable. The best player in the world. People are waiting. Entertainment from you? Okay, these are pretty sincere, even though they are in broken English. Sincerity transcends the bounds of language anyway, so I guess I get the gist. I want to see who else has the most Facebook subscribers. Shakira is second place, followed by Vin Diesel. Shakira, what a beautiful banner. I love your banner, Shakira. I just want to tell you. I just love it's so quaint and colorful. Okay, this is her post about a police officer. Heart, thank you. Aha, just as I thought. Anger Abul Kalam Azad, trying to sell face masks in the Shakira comment section on Facebook. Where's your class, man, huh? Where's your integrity? All right, oh my God. What do I have here? I have oh my Jesus. We have what is essentially I'm gonna guess the entirety of the Bible, put in here by Sunil Kumar Ghosh. And he says, I want to say about lovely woman in Christ. Who can find a virtuous woman? Such a woman is a rare gem, indeed. Thankfully, on the pages of the Holy Bible, we can find numerous illustrations of... And he goes on to quote so many things in the Bible about women, because I guess he has like a crush on Shakira, and he follows this up with... And then I guess follows it up with his address and P.O. box, as well as his email and his phone number.
I'm not going to encourage it, but if anybody wants to send Mr. Gosh any fan mail or send him a nice email or even give him a text, he seems a little lonely. That might help him out. Plugs. Okay. I think I got the gist of this. Let us return to look at one more. The great, the mighty Vin Diesel. There he is. Goddamn. Okay, he's talking about his movie Bloodshot. Let's check out some comments. Vin was awesome, but the video direction editing could have been better. It felt cut off or too short. Ooh, some film criticism in the comments here. Oh, but this guy, Jason Saylor, replied. Hey, Shirley. Check out this cool American t-shirt for you. Paresh says, would you like to chat with Vin Diesel on Hangouts just the way I chatted with him yesterday in videos chat him? This is Vin Diesel Hangouts Gmail address, so you can message him on Hangouts and also make a video call. Oh, I can meet Vin. That's, who knew Vin Diesel's email was Vin926311? Of course, his favorite numbers. Watched it last night. Both my wife and I had a difficult time staying awake. Oh, is that a diss on Bloodshot? We continued to encourage each other to at least respect the artist's work and finish watching it. We barely made it. Wow. This guy is sneak dissing Vin Diesel in his own Facebook comments. I also threw 60% of the movie. I do appreciate the honest criticism though. There's some good and bad stuff here. It's a mixed bag. Surprisingly, have enjoyed the Vin Diesel Facebook comment section more than any other comment section on Facebook. You haters out there, yes, you have a right to your opinion, but seriously, if you can't say something nice to Vin and all those involved in the movie, I know what the box office for your movie has taken a hit due to the virus. For that, I'm sorry. But for me, a new mom who couldn't really get out to the theater, I'm glad it was made available for digital download during this time. I was very excited to see it for the first trailer. You all should be very proud of your work. The movie is great. Thank you, Shauna. Vin Diesel should stay out of hero action movies. Of course, he'd play such an overpowered hero, just like how he's basically a god on Fast and Furious. Rolling my eyes. Are you so insecure that you have to ruin your characters by making your characters overpowered and unbelievable just to boost your self-esteem? Jamie Gibbons, speaking truth to the power that is Vin Diesel. Wow. I have been shocked by the amount of truth and honesty in this comment section. All right, I think I have enough information to do my scoring. Just incredible. That was a wild, the Vin Diesel comment section is a wild ride, let me tell you. Facebook, that was an emotional rollercoaster. Wow, okay. Sincerity, there was a lot of sincerity. Mostly, it was honestly incredibly sincere and brutally honest, especially in Vin Diesel's section. So I'm gonna have to give sincerity a 5. I did not expect to be ranking anything from Facebook this high. Sanity. There was mostly sanity going on. There wasn't a lot of garbage piling up. I'm gonna give sanity a 4. There wasn't a lot of randomness. Silliness. There wasn't that many. Okay, I laughed a lot. Not on purpose. Most of the laughing I did was because of how bizarre it was. I don't think any of those were intentional jokes. That being said, I don't think I should really discount how much fun I did have reading those comments. So I'm gonna give silliness a 3. Stupidness, there was a lot of stupidness. That gets probably a 1. Spam, there was a good amount of spam. People were trying to sell masks again and like cords or trying to like promote their own stuff. Spam definitely also gets a 1. Worst spam I've seen so far. And stealing, I didn't see anybody stealing comments. Unless you count the people reposting the spam. 3. Yeah, why not? And it all tallies up to 17. Interesting. Just barely inched its way above YouTube and Instagram. I did not expect that. I had it out for Facebook. I do not like Facebook. I thought it would just tank completely, but it's holding its own right now. Oof. All right, let's move on to our last segment, TikTok. One of the newest contenders. I'm going to go to the trending, or whatever they call it, the popular page of TikTok, and I'm going to go through the trending hashtags and see what I can find. Let's start with the Scoob dance. I guess there's for the new Scooby-Doo movie, there's a dumbass dance. Oh boy. Okay, so what happened to Zac Efron? He looks like he aged 20 years. Makes me sad. It seems so forced, it hurts. Yeah, probably. There's some decent chuckle-worthy things. My dog is dead, okay. Okay, this isn't really resulting in what I want. So we're gonna go to the For You section and just kinda scroll. Okay, this has lots of views and he's like doing weird shit with effects. A lot of filler here. I'm not,
not seeing a lot of good, like, good points. Hit different, a lot of hit difference, a lot of colloquial young people speak. Yeah, okay, I think I got the general vibe. Not too impressed. I mean, it's just kind of, you know, whatever. So yeah, okay, let's score it. TikTok. Sincerity, I guess there was comments that were sincere. 3. Sanity, there was some randomness, not as much as I expected, so I'm gonna have to do, give him a 2 for sanity. Silliness, there were certain points where I did laugh. I'm unfortunately gonna have to rank it, I guess a 3? Yeah, I'll give him a 3. Stupidness, there was a lot of stuff that made me kind of roll my eyes. Stupidness is gonna probably get a 1. Spam, wasn't really any spam, so I'm gonna have to give them a 5 for spam. Stealing, I didn't really see much stealing with my own personal eyes, but I have to assume that stealing happens a lot on TikTok. I'm gonna give them a 2 for stealing. So when you add it all up, they also get a 16. So that's, okay, well let's just see what the scores are right now in total. As you can see, I have all the scores here. YouTube with 16, Instagram with 16, Twitter with 21, Facebook with 17, and TikTok with 16, and these are all out of a total of 30. Without a doubt, we can say that Twitter is the best. They have the best comment section in their replies. They were the funniest to me. To me, had the overall best quality. But we have a 3-way tie for worst, which is unfortunate for me because this whole point I was trying to figure out what had the worst, and I have a 3-way tie for the worst. So we have a tie between YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok with all 16. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a speed round. I'm gonna go on YouTube, go on Instagram, go on TikTok, look at the first comment I can possibly see, and give that a ranking out of 5, and then we'll have a definitive ranking of what is the worst. This is a grand battle royale to see who has the worst comment section. Lightning round. We're gonna start with YouTube. Let me go back to the trending page. There seems to be a new second trending art. Well, that was fast. This is a death battle between Obi-Wan Kenobi and an anime character. First comment I see, I'm just gonna go bang. You've got to make an alternate ending. I would say that was a decent comment. Out of 5, I guess I would give that comment a 3. It's not bad, but it's not good. Okay, Instagram. I'm gonna go to the explore page. I'm just gonna go crazy, go wild, go nuts. I found this picture of a Garfield sheriff, so I'm going to go to this person's page and just see if they have any. Okay, there's 4 comments on this meme. Hi, Jim. Hi, Jim. I guess a 4. I don't know why. I just like that it's wholesome. I like it. Okay. TikTok. I'm on the For You page. I'm just gonna go blah, 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 blah. Give me, oh geez, there's some creepy shit on here. Okay, this is a hand. So one comment that says first. You know what you get for saying first? You get a 1. Because you're first. It's so important to you. Okay, there you go, TikTok. You get a 1. YouTube gets a 3. Instagram gets a 4. TikTok gets a 1. That means TikTok is the worst comment section of all comment sections. It was a close match. Went down to the wire. But TikTok clinches it. So when it comes to comment sections, our rankings are Twitter's the best. Then Facebook. Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. Surprising, I know. But TikTok is the worst. There we have it. There's the official rankings of comment sections from best to worst, officially curated by me. And, so. Cool! I spent most of an afternoon doing this. You know, just for fun, let's take a look at my comment sections, right? Let's see what people have to say about my videos. Here's one of my last videos. Let's go down. No comments. Got it. Sure. Maybe it's like, because there's probably more conversation happening on like a more controversial, like my tier list. My tier list video might have more things for people to say. No, just no comments there either. I think just the videos, they speak for themselves, right? They speak for themselves. You don't need to comment on that. It's self-explanatory.